with Wayne Paterson this morning from Anteris. Wayne, good morning.
Good morning, Andrew.
Good to speak, Wayne. Look, Anteris, big news recently. You've taken a 30% stake here in a new venture. Tell us a bit about the project, firstly, from a medical perspective.
Yeah, great. Thanks, Drew. We're very excited by this, but before I get into it, I just want to introduce Dr. Babat and Dr. Madhuri, both who are integral to the new project. From a medical perspective, this helps certainly from a perspective from the company build out our portfolio, but we're entering another space like we did with DuraVar, where there's a fairly big unmet medical need. It's a fairly big space. It's about $4 billion. There is room for entry for an innovative product. So I'd like to hand over to Dr. Papat to talk a little bit about the medical side of repair.
Absolutely. So as DuraVar addresses the aortic valve, this new product will address the mitral valve, which is really underserved at present all over the world. And as a surgeon, I've been involved in this for 30 years, and we know that preserving the patient's own valve is very important in this space. So the repair product, so to speak, is what we surgeons tend to do. We like to repair the patient's valve so that it retains everything else and takes away a lot of other challenges if we replace the heart valve. So this product will address that unmet need, but also give an advantage over other treatments.
Yeah, thanks, Vinny. Chris?
Yeah, I think Vinny's point is perfectly said. Surgical repair has been the gold standard for a long time, but now we've seen the transcatheter edge-to-edge repair is an incredibly effective treatment right now, as was TAVR when it first came to the market. But there remains still an unmet need for kind of further evolution of the products, I believe, to really get the optimal benefit for these patients. And I believe this, you know, really quite brilliant idea and project that Vinny really has initiated originally, has the ability, just like DuraVar will, to really address this need for a very broad population.
And just to be clear, we're talking about the mitral versus the aortic valve. So for DuraVar, we're talking about aortic. For this product, we're talking about the mitral valve area.
Wayne, you did touch on it a bit earlier, but tell us a bit more about the market potential for this product.
Yeah, so I think we've taken the same kind of approach we took with TAVR, which is to look into the market. There's a couple of players already there, kind of move forward and innovate on top of what's available and what's known in the space. And again, we're taking a very physician-centric approach to this, which we did with DuraVar. And you're looking roughly at a space worth about $4 billion and certainly growing. And we believe we've got a culture of high innovation now, as we've seen with the TAVR product DuraVar, that we can iterate and improve on the current available products.
How much do these products typically sell for?
Yeah, so the repair products currently in the space are roughly, and they equate to probably the same price as a TAVR, essentially about $25,000 per unit.
And so how does this impact, Wayne, the work that you're doing here with DuraVar?
Yeah, very important, Andrew. I think, that the focus for the company clearly is on DuraVar. We're entering clinical studies, of course, with the FDA, EFS commencing and other things going on. We have got a separate structure to help make sure that we've got the focus that allows us to move this project forward and maintain our focus on DuraVar at the same time. So we'll have a very focused, dedicated team on this. It's not a high resource proposition. It's not a high cost proposition. In fact, the deal is calibrated such that as we hit success milestones, we will be able to keep moving forward with that as well.
You mentioned before there's a couple of existing players within the space for repair. Are these similar competitors to DuraVar?
The companies actually that are involved are yes, very similar. We've got our friends at Abbott St. Jude and our friends over at Edwards are currently in the space at the moment with products that are in the market, and we believe we can iterate on top of those.
So what's your message here, Wayne, to investors seeing an expansion of your portfolio?
Yeah, look, I think, a lot of opportunity, low risk, high reward kind of approach. Obviously, it increases the portfolio of Anteris, makes us, even more attractive from a point of view of being a med tech company in the structural heart space. I think from an investment thesis point of view, we've got that, legacy of innovation. We work with great physicians who are able to see a problem because they would deal with it all day, every day in the clinic and iterate on what's currently available. So there's obviously a high chance of success. With a product like this. And I think it just improves the investability of Anteris moving forward. And it gives us another shot on goal for a multi-billion dollar product.
Gentlemen, good to see you this morning. Thanks very much.
Thanks, Andrew. Thank you. Appreciate your time.
Appreciate it.